A call to boycott the University of Alabama generating conversation everywhere, including on campus.
WVTM 13's Chip Scarborough spoke to UA law students about the controversy centered around their school.
It's not fair to us.
Maggie Clanton just graduated from the University of Alabama School of Law, named after Florida attorney Hugh Culverhouse Jr. Clanton says she's bothered by recent comments from Culverhouse calling for students to boycott the University of Alabama because of Alabama's recent ban on abortions.
Well, I thought it was kind of unfair to punish the law students or punish the UA students for something that we really didn't have a say in.
The university says it all started last week when Culverhouse asked that a $10 million donation he made to the law school be returned after what UA calls an ongoing dispute involving how the law school operates. UA says the dispute has nothing to do with the abortion law. Recent law school graduate Catherine Vining says she's still trying to make sense of things.
It was a little bizarre, I think, to hear someone say something like that. I think partly because the reflection of the state legislator isn't necessarily a reflection of the university within itself, especially considering the fact that we have more and more out-of-state students than in-state students at this point.
And students I talk to say they not only support the University of Alabama, but they also support Tuscaloosa as a whole because this is their community.
Seems more detrimental and hurtful.
I feel like we're already kind of punished enough with this abortion ban, and it's not fair to boycott us anymore and hurt the economy or hurt people coming into Tuscaloosa.
The university is expected to return more than $20 million in donations to Culverhouse. UA says donors cannot dictate university administration. In Tuscaloosa, Chip Scarborough, WVTM 13.
We spoke to Culverhouse by phone a short time ago. He tells us his recent comments about boycotting UA were misunderstood. He says he's calling for a boycott of all Alabama businesses. He also tells us UA has not contacted him about returning that money.